Hey guys, this is Austin, and today I'm here with a video showing you how to get iOS 6 features now. There are some nice new additions in iOS 6, but almost all of them you can get today by jailbreaking. If you haven't jailbroken your iPhone, iPod Touch, or iPad yet, it's very easy, and you can follow this tutorial first if you're on iOS 5.1.1, and then come back to this video. One of the bigger announcements is Facebook integration in iOS 6. To get this today on iOS 5, all you need to do is download Fusion, which is available for $3 in Cydia. Fusion allows you to quickly update your status from anywhere. I have it configured to open by double-tapping the status bar, but you can change it to a wide range of activation options. Inside, you'll see the normal iOS tweet menu with the option to add your location, upload a picture, or post a song you're currently listening to. Fusion not only has Facebook integration, but also Twitter, Foursquare, and MySpace. You know, if you're still in 2007 for some reason. It also works system-wide. Anytime there's a tweet option in an app, it automatically opens Fusion, so you can also choose to post to Facebook or the other social networks. Siri integration is also included. Post status to Facebook saying, "Hello world."
As you wish, master.
Not bad, huh? iOS 6 also brings an improved mail app. For this, I love Sparrow, an email client available in the App Store for $3. Sparrow handles multiple accounts along with multiple email signatures, and a UI that really puts the default mail app to shame. There are lots of excellent little gestures to navigate through your mail quickly, and even though it's lacking push notification support right now, for me, the trade-off is worth it. I've been using Sparrow for the last few months, and wouldn't trade it even for the new iOS 6 mail app. In iOS 6, you can finally open apps with Siri, but my friend Nick Frey has already created a Cydia tweet to do this months ago, called VoiceUtils. It's a straightforward tweet, but it's free and works very well. Open Jetpack Joyride. It might be a year or two late, but iOS 6 also finally brings the ability to use FaceTime over 3G. This is something you can do easily if you are jailbroken, with the help of an app called 3G Unrestrictor, which is available in Cydia for $4. Alright, so I'm now using 3G Unrestrictor to do FaceTime over 3G. Now to help me demo this, of course, I have my good friend. Would you like to introduce yourself?
Yeah, I'm Hank from youtube.com/logicallyhank.
Cool. So you guys definitely go check him out. So as you guys can see here, he looks very, very good, pretty much just exactly like on Wi-Fi. How's it on your end?
It's decent. There's some lag, but yeah. It's not unusable.
On top of allowing you to make FaceTime calls over 3G or 4G, it also allows you to download anything at all over cellular. For example, the App Store doesn't allow large apps to be downloaded, or to watch high-quality YouTube videos over 3G, but with 3G Unrestrictor, it tricks apps into believing you are on Wi-Fi, so it's universal. There are also included SB settings toggles to restrict apps back to Wi-Fi if you're going over your data usage, but otherwise this is a basically must-have tweak. There are many other features you can get now between the App Store and Cydia, including turn-by-turn navigation apps, more Siri mods, and much more, but these are my favorites. If you guys enjoyed the video, I'd really appreciate it if you could leave it a thumbs up. And if you're interested in more videos like this, be sure to subscribe.